I am
Super Nerd.
Die-ho! Holy cow, that's a long run from the lab to here.
So anyways, where are the games?
Bring on games!
Greetings, monsters from Monsterville, it's me, Dr. Gavin and Mr. Hyde, and welcome back to your brand new Game Nerd episode. Now, who ever heard of Batman, the video game for the NES? Wait, no one ever heard of this? Well, you should know now, because I'm gonna reveal this thing! Batman, the video game for NES was made by Sunsoft, who made really great games back then, and they were pretty good at making movie games, and this was one of them, which was Batman, and it was based off of the Tim Burton film of the 1989 classic called Batman, which is one of my favorite films. And Batman Returns happens to be my favorite Batman film, but onto that later on. So Batman for the NES is a side-scroller platformer, which is really great. I mean, holy cow, this game is actually amazing. It's a really fun game. Let's talk about the gameplay. And the gameplay is probably the best side-scroller for a superhero game by far. It's really good and really fun to play. The game starts off easy, then gets pretty hard. I mean, this game can be hard. It's like the Sunsoft version of Castlevania, which is a excellent horror side-scroller game. Now, you got four attacks. The first one is punching, which is a really good punching hitbox type of deal. Really good. Then you got your Bat Boomerang, which is probably the best out of the four, besides of the punch. Then you got the gun, which is probably the worst because it only shoots in one dimension, which... sure, the other ones shoot or punches or whatever goes into one way, but I feel like they got their own specialty. But this one just feels a bit off about it. It's like the Game Boy Batman, if it was a weapon in the NES game, but it's okay. Then you got the Bat Bomb thing where you throw turns into three different Bat Boomerangs, which is probably my third favorite out of the bunch, and it's really good to defeat some enemies with. Let's talk about the graphics, and oh my god, the graphics are really amazing. I mean, it captures that graphic book style to it, yeah, making it as its own film type of game. Pretty much, it's like Picasso type of artwork meets any artwork for the NES. I mean, wow, it's just a really beautiful game to look at. It got tons of dark colors and everything just looks like a comic book. In fact, you can say that this is probably the best comic book looking game by far. And you can tell how much detail they put into the game. I mean, it really does look beautiful at the end. No joke, I would love to get a screenshot of the game and hang it up on my wall to just remember it, so on. But into epicness, Batman-ness. The controls to the game are very good. I mean, B does the punching, A jumps, and your jumps feel really good. And I do feel a bit amazed how good the jumping is. No joke, I want to take the jumping in the game and want to put in the sack so I can jump like Batman when I'm doing a happy sack type of jumping, you know, the ones that you go in the sack and you do a race, which is called a sack race.
I don't know why I said happy sack then.
But sadly, there's one complaint about the controls. The start button is selecting weapons, while the select button is for pausing the game. You heard me right? Start, selecting, select, pause. You got to be kidding me. Now, in 90% of NES games, usually the start is for pausing and the select is for switching, but no, they got to mess it up. Now, that's the only minor thing to complain about. I mean, the game is really awesome. In fact, I would call it a almost perfect NES game, but it doesn't make sense how the start is for selecting and the select is for pausing. I mean, selecting it has the word select in the controller. In fact, see this? Select. Select. You select to pause and start to switch weapons or selecting weapons. Shouldn't it be like the other way around instead of the you know what? But that's the only thing that I complain about. Just the select and start are a bit backwards. But anyways, this game is really fun and it's really good and it is just an amazing game and I will highly recommend it. Like a 10 out of 10 recommendation. So overall, I give the game 2 thumbs up. Now, this game is really awesome. I highly recommend it. And if you want to look for a great superhero game or look for a good Batman game, I highly recommend it. So yeah, I give this game 2 thumbs up. Really good. And I highly recommend it. And I hope you guys enjoy the next episode. So yeah. See y'all later. Please subscribe. Please leave a like and comment if you want to. And yeah, see y'all later and bye.